Okay, so the question is, what are these sunspots anyway? And the clue to them is the fact that astronomers found that the magnetic field within the region of a sunspot is much stronger than in surrounding part. Basically, what is done is, this is the visual image, and then one actually allows through a slit only the light coming from this along this line to enter this spectrometer. And basically what is found out is that the spectral lines within this region here, when within the spot, is actually split into three parts. And it turns out, quantum mechanics tells us that when you place, say, a hydrogen atom in a magnetic field, then the energy of the level depends on how the magnetic moment of the electron is oriented relative to the field, whether it's parallel or the opposite. If it's parallel, you will get lower energy than if it is the opposite. And that's the reason why there is not one, but two energy levels in addition to the normal one that depend on the orientation of the magnetic moment of the electron relative to the field. And you get this splitting only where the magnetic field is very strong. So in this way, they found out that the magnetic field of the sun is much stronger within the spot than in the surrounding area. We are pretty sure that we understand how they form and what is their relationship to the magnetic field. Even Galileo, remember, found that the sun is rotating by observing how the sunspots move on the surface of the sun. And when you do the analysis, it turns out that the parts of the sun closer to its equator are moving faster than parts on the surface of the sun closer to its poles. It turns out that a segment on the sun's equator makes one complete revolution in about 25 days. And those parts closer to the pole, they make one complete revolution in 30 days. It takes them 5 days longer. So here is the initial moment, say go, right? And because the parts closer to the equator move faster, after some time, these lines will be, areas will be distributed like so. So what is the consequence of that? Well, it is the consequence of that is that as a result, the magnetic field lines become twisted. So let's focus just on one magnetic field line. So as the sun is undergoing this so-called differential rotation, parts near the equator move faster. So what will happen is that the magnetic field line will become wrapped more and more. In fact, so tightly wrapped that it would develop kinks. Just like if you take a rubber band, right, and you start twisting it. After a while, there will be little kinks that appear on it. So the same thing happens with the magnetic field lines of the sun. They get wound so much by this differential rotation of the sun that they start forming these kinks. So how are the kinks related to the sunspots? Well, remember what I told you about how charges move in the magnetic field. They are trapped by the magnetic field. So here is one particular kink, right? The magnetic field line coming out above the surface of the sun and then coming down. Well, the charges coming from interior, right, from the hot material brought up by convection currents, they cannot come into these parts because there is already material frozen into magnetic field lines. So these two footings are forbidden to the material, to the hot gas rising from underneath. Because, you know, there's nobody else who can occupy my space right now, right? I'm occupying this space. So there is already a material trapped by the magnetic field lines, and the hot stuff coming from underneath cannot come here. As a result, the footings of this kink are colder than the surrounding area. And as a result, their temperature is lower. Because remember, luminosity is proportional to the fourth power of temperature. Lower temperature at the footing of this kink will produce lower luminosity, which we perceive with our eye as a dark spot. It's not a hole, nothing, it's just a regular surface of the sun that is cooler than the surrounding area. And of course, around these kinks, you can have these spectacular things formed, these so-called prominences. This material from within the sun being trapped by the magnetic field lines forming these plumes of material that, you know, juts out and is trapped by the magnetic field. Okay, so here are the actual photos of three prominences. And again, Earth is drawn to the scale so that you can appreciate the size of these things. Right, so if we have the surface of the sun, there is this bundle of magnetic field lines that forms a kink. And the magnetic field basically freezes the material at the footing of the kinks so that the convection currents cannot bring hot stuff there. They can bring hot gas between the footings and away from them. So these regions are blocked off because the material is trapped there already. And as a result, these footings have a lower temperature. And often around these kinks there are prominences.